an article saying that the House just passed a bill that they're going to automatically register men from 18 to 26 for war, okay? And all I want to say is to America, good luck with that. These new little niggas are TikTokers, baby. These motherfuckers ain't gonna fight no war. We gonna die. You gonna die. You might as well just keep motherfucking investing money and got guns. Cause these new kids, you wanna send these new kids to fight these wars? The TikTok fucking hip shakers? Out of your mind. This is a new America, baby. This ain't the 19 motherfucking. Nah, like, seriously, you're gonna draft these kids that be TikToking all day to fight them, what? Most likely, what, them Russians? Them motherfuckers that be fighting bears and shit? And motherfucking climbing mountains to go to school and whatever? I got some news for you, motherfuckers.
In this video, we're gonna talk about what Cardi B said concerning the upcoming draft. All right, and please excuse me, I kind of caught a little brain cramp for a moment. Anyway, all praise to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, double honor to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. And this video will be entitled Cardi B Was Right About You Little Ninjas and the Upcoming Draft. Or I may just, you know, make it a response. Cardi B speaks on the draft bill. Now, before we get into that, I wanted to mention, first and foremost, I want to mention this video. I basically got the opening clip for this video from, I mean, brothers shared it on the chat, but Elder Karatazar from GMS Vegas, he did a video on it, and I was listening to his video, and then I remembered that brothers had shared it on the chat. So his video is entitled Reality Will Set In. Cardi B scoffs at bill mandating military draft for ages 18 to 26 in US. Good video. I was checking it out. And like I said, when I saw his video, that made me remember that brothers had shared it on the chat, and I went over there and checked it out. Made me want to do my own video. Now, yesterday I was listening to this video from the elder brother Micah Allah from GMS Los Angeles. I think it's the Antelope Valley brothers. This is the elder brother right here. If you haven't subscribed to his channel as well, that's GMS Las Vegas. But on this brother's channel, this brother's channel is GMS Inspiration of the Almighty. And he had a live stream entitled Draft. These little ninjas will be judged in World War III. And I mean, he had me cracking up, but he was true, you know, 100% correct about what he was saying. And I had to kind of consider what he was saying, because he did say that the Most High judged men in the past, a lot of men, the Most High sent them in the war to die. You know, such as King Saul, I believe Ahab, you know, among others. The Most High sent them into battle where they wind up getting killed. And that's an excellent point. So all these things together, you know, the two elder brothers' videos plus what Cardi B was talking about. I mean, Cardi B, she ain't nobody we would, you know, take too serious anything that she would say. But in this regard, she was absolutely right. These little TikTok belly dancing little weak men in Babylon the Great, these young guys, they're not interested in going to war. They don't care nothing about Babylon the Great. They don't care about America. All they care about is their hair, or they, whatever sport they're playing, what girl they're chasing, playing video games or whatever it is. But you know what? They're a product of their environment, and they're a product of what Babylon the Great has spawned. So you know what? That's too bad. Now, in the grand scheme of things, you may say, why y'all, you know, why y'all always talking so negative? Well, this is the thing. We're the prophets of doom. This is Jeremiah 28 verse 8. It says, the prophets that have been before me and before thee of old prophesied both against many countries. See, so we prophesy against these countries. And at the end of the day, we're against all of them. We're not here for Russia. We don't give a fuck about Russia. We don't care about the fucking Palestinians. We don't care about the Israelis, the Americans, you know, Ukraine. We don't give a shit about none of them. China, they can all be destroyed. We don't give a damn, because this is not our rest. And this world, we want it to fall. We want this world empire, this world system to fall. And it's in the scriptures. The prophets that have been before me and before thee of old prophesied both against many countries and against great kingdoms. Of what? Of war and of evil and of pestilence. So, and we don't care about you two-third ninjas. You two-third niggas. We want you niggas to die. The Most High needs to line you up and send your little badasses off into the conflict so you perish. And rightfully so, because a lot of you are a bunch of damn weirdos.
The House just passed a bill.
You know, what's that word? You're narcissistic. You have no respect. You lack integrity. You really don't even have a purpose on the planet.
The
you just in the way.
A bill that That's all you are. Automatically register.
The Lord don't need you, and He can't really use you in the condition that you're in. You won't repent. So yeah, we like the fact that the Lord's gonna send your little badasses, your little adolescent demons, send your ass to World War III to fight. At least die with honor, because that's what's gonna happen. I don't know if you're gonna die with honor, but you're gonna die. So when we go to Matthew 13. And you know what? I ain't going to read it. I was going to read a particular scripture. Let's just go ahead and read some of these. Now, I was listening. Like I said, I was listening to the elder brother, Karatazar from GMS Las Vegas. And he brought out a great scripture. Now, I'm going to start here at Jeremiah 51, verse 25. It says, "Behold, I am against thee, O destroying mountain, saith the Lord." See, the Most High is against Babylon the Great. He's against America. But he's also against Russia. He's against all of the whole world. And you people out there, you just because you one of us, you know, we come from the same race or whatever, we don't give a shit. We just read your description, Jeremiah 28. Cardi B was right about what she was saying about you little two-third ass niggas. And she gonna probably, you know, she ain't going to fight, but she gonna be destroyed herself, man. Let's read this again. "Behold, I am against thee, O destroying mountain, saith the Lord, Yahweh, which destroys all the earth." Right? "And I will stretch out my hand upon thee and roll thee down from the rocks and will make thee a burnt mountain." So the Most High is against this place that's destroying all the earth. Interfering, you know, causing wars and all kinds of things going on the earth. So the Most High is against you, and He's gonna burn this place. But before He does it, He's gonna make a lot of believers, and I don't mean in a positive sense. I mean He's gonna prove to you that we were telling the truth, and that your lack of repentance was a slap in the face for you two-third ass Israelites out there. Verse 26 says, "And they shall not take of thee a stone for a corner, nor a stone for foundations, but thou shalt be desolate forever, saith the Lord." And this is how we know that when it says Babylon, well, it's going to say Babylon later on, that this is a prophecy of Babylon the Great, which is America, because people still dwell in ancient Babylon, although it was, you know, laid waste. It says, "Set ye up a standard in the land, blow the trumpet among the nations, prepare the nations against her, call together against her the kingdoms of Ararat, Meni, and Ashkenaz, appoint a captain against her, because the horses to come up cause the horses to come up as the rough caterpillars. Prepare against her the nations with the kings of the Medes, the captains thereof, and all the rulers thereof, and all the land of his dominion." And like we tell you, that the Persians, the Medes, represent today will be the Russians, because the Russians occupy the land of the Medes. Verse 29 says, "And the land shall tremble and sorrow, for every purpose of the Lord shall be performed against Babylon, to make the land of Babylon a desolation without an inhabitant." See, again, it's telling you that it's not going to be any inhabitants over here. This is going to be a desert. This is how we know that this is a scripture pertaining to, or a prophecy pertaining to, Babylon the Great. Okay, because as we said, ancient Babylon over there around about Mesopotamia, Iraq, people still live there. So it says, "To make the land of Babylon a desolation without an inhabitant." This is the point where the elder brother brought this scripture out. "The mighty men of Babylon have forborne to fight. They have remained in their holes. Their might hath failed. They became as women. They have burned her dwelling places. Her bars are broken." Right? These jakes is scared. All the people scared. And there was a video I did some years back, 2 years ago probably. It was called Buyer's Remorse. Be careful what you ask for, you just might get it. Because why? Because, you know, these people, they don't want to go fight. Matter of fact, I might bring that up. Let's see if we can bring it up. And I'll play the intro for you. And you can see that this person, this is the spirit that's on these people. And you know what? I may actually save that. I may save it for the women, because I got a video coming on the females being told that they're going to have to go to the draft as well. Let's see if I can't even look this thing up, man. Just bear with me here. See if it'll come up. Yeah, there it is. One brother reposted it. Yeah, we just play his. Listen to this. This intro.
Ooh, I'm gonna try to keep it together. But so I just want to make this TikTok because I was just on live this morning, and of course we all know Russia invaded Ukraine. But in this TikTok, like, of course, you know, okay, I'm in uniform, everybody knows what's going on. So of course everybody coming in with the Ukraine, Russia, and all of that, you know, comments or whatever, asking questions. And I'm just like, I'm not here for that, I'm not addressing any of that. But then, like, it's just like, I really hate it how people are so insensitive, especially, like, and it's like, it's the civilians, and but they're so insensitive to, like, what military people really go through. This is my first term, and like, it's like, y'all, like, what makes me so mad is, like, y'all are so insensitive. Y'all want to talk about, oh, this is what you signed up for, this is what you, nobody goes into the military wanting to go to war, thinking they're going to go to war. I'm financed, for crying out loud. Nobody thinks this is going to happen. But like, civilians, y'all get to go home, y'all get to go to y'all families, y'all go to work, y'all know what y'all life is going to be. My life is so unpredictable. I could be deployed within the next few days. Like, I really just, like, I didn't come into the army for this. And it's just, it really, like, it kind of, it hurts me, like, and I don't really like to let stuff affect me, but this is affecting me because this is my life. But I if anything, I really just want people to be like, be more sensitive to the situation, because this is my life we're talking about. Like, there's potential that, like, honestly, like, there's potential that anybody going over there can't come back, won't come back. So it's just, I just really, I don't even know why I'm making this, but it's just like, people talking about the situation, like, please just keep in mind, these are real people, people that have families, people that have children, and y'all making jokes about it, and y'all this, and y'all all of that, and these trolls. I'm like, these are real people, real life situations. Like, please just be sensitive to stuff, because, like, I'm not gonna lie to any of y'all, I'm scared as hell right now. I'm just,
oh. Right. And you can see it. She is super scared. Okay. And this was from, you know, years ago, a couple of years back, when I still had a GMS Narrative SC7 page. So, you know, that video, and I'm probably going to wind up using that again in another video that I do. But it's the same sentiment that's going on now. Let's read the scripture again. Jeremiah 50. I'm sorry, it was 51. Jeremiah 51 and verse, I started 29. It says, and the land shall tremble in sorrow, for every purpose of the Lord shall be performed against Babylon, to make the land of Babylon a desolation without an inhabitant. The mighty men of Babylon have forborne to fight. They have remained in their holds. Their might hath failed. They became as women. They have burned her dwelling places. Her bars are broken. Now, if you go to another translation, it says, NLT, her mightiest warriors no longer fight. They stand their barracks. Their courage is gone. They have become like women. The invaders have burned the houses in the city and Salakia, and broken down the city gates. So, you know, the people here, man, these people are used to pleasure. You know, they're used to luxury. They don't want to go and fight. They don't want nothing to do with going into World War III, but that's too damn bad. And, you know, so going back to the title, you know, Cardi B spoke on the draft bill, but she was absolutely right. She was right about you. You are you weaklings in America. And I may wind up just changing the title. Cardi B was right about you, American weaklings. So as we bring it out, you know, Cardi B was absolutely right about you, TikTok demons. And you like that because of Babylon the Great. Now, I want to read you here. Before we read that, let's go to Isaiah 13. Because there's going to be a draft. As we told you that a while back. We've been said that. Our apostles and elders and then us, we've been telling you and warning you people about everything that the Lord is going to do. Isaiah 13 and verse 6, it says, judgment on the day of the Lord. It says, how ye, for the day of the Lord is at hand. It shall come as a destruction from the Almighty. Therefore shall all hands be faint, and every man's heart shall melt. And they shall be afraid. Pangs and sorrows shall take hold of them. They shall be in pain as a woman that travaileth. And that's a woman in child labor. They shall be amazed one at another. Their faces shall be as flames. And we can see if we can read that here. All right. It says, NLT, our people and people are terrified. Pangs of anguish grip them like those of a woman in labor. They look helplessly at one another, their faces aflame with fear. Now this is really on the literal day of the Lord, when they, you know, they hear them nuclear sirens going off. But before that, the people gonna be afraid. It goes on in verse 9, behold the day cometh, the day of the Lord, excuse me, behold, the day of the Lord, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, cometh, cruel, both with wrath and fierce anger, to lay the land desolate, and he shall destroy the sinners thereof out of it. How's the Lord going to destroy the sinners? He's going to do it by nuclear destruction. That's what's going to happen over here. But those that go to fight in World War III, the Lord's going to judge you a different way. You're still going to get, and some of you going to get hit with nuclear fire. He goes on, for the stars of heaven and the constellations thereof shall not give their light. The sun shall be darkened in its going forth, and the moon shall not cause her light to shine. Because why? Because the heavens, everything's going to be blacked out from all the smoke from the nuclear warheads coming. And from the fire, smoke, and wind, radiation, and heat. It goes on, and I will punish the world for their evil and the wicked for their iniquity. This is a good part. And I will cause the arrogancy of the proud to cease, and will lay low the heartedness of the terrible. Right. And I was watching, you know, going back to what Cardi B said, these niggas are some TikTok dancers. These little weak, feminine motherfuckers all over TikTok, Instagram, your little social media demons. And Lord, get rid of you. And I may change it. You know, I think I'm going to call it Cardi B was right about you, social media TikTok demons. You social media TikTok demons. Cardi B was right about the draft, and you social media TikTok demons. I want to make the title as provocative as possible. We want to provoke you to fear, more fear. We love it. It's hilarious what the Lord is going to do. And it's going to get a whole lot worse. And really, there's no way out. You people, really, most of you are too stupid to realize how much trouble that you're really in. The Lord says, and I will cause the arrogancy of the proud to cease. You people are arrogant, especially the young generation. You are arrogant. You have no respect. Let me see if I can bring this scripture up. Behave himself. Salakia. Just bear with me here. Let's see if we can bring this up. Woo. Yeah, this is Isaiah 3 and 4. It says, and I will give children to be their princes, and babes shall rule over them. And the people shall be oppressed, every one by another, every one by his neighbor. And this is talking about the people of the Israelites. See, because it says the Most High will remove the leaders. And this is what you've done. A lot of you are very disrespectful. I got two sons, you know, and they grown men. And if I call them on the phone, most of the time they won't even answer. One of them will swipe the call. He'll swipe left. He won't even answer. Right? He's a little badass. You know the reason why he's doing that is because he's angry with me. Because why? Because he want. Now this is, check this out. Our kids want us to send them money, although I already pay. Already pay child support. Just because you're a grown man and you broke, that'll be not supposed to help you. You need to see your mother for money. So you mad because I won't give him money anymore. I can't give you money, dude. That's just an example. So like, if you're getting personal, but that's the shit that burns me up. Here it is, I'm still paying for your badass. You a grown man, right? Approaching 30, but you'll call me for money, but won't call your mama for money, and I'm still paying her. What am I giving her money for? Anyway. Amazing. And the people shall be oppressed, every one by another, every one by his neighbor. The child shall behave himself proudly against the ancient. And that can be children, little kids, on up to grown-ups. Because you're still, still children. The child shall behave himself proudly against the ancient and the base against the honorable. You see? When a man shall take hold of his brother of the house. Let me read it again. When a man shall take hold of his brother of the house of his father, saying, thou hast clothing, be thou our ruler, and let this ruin be under thy hand. Which really, the point was made in that scripture already. So, we got there's a lot of disorder and chaos in Babylon the Great, but the Most High gonna straighten it all out. He gonna straighten out you little TikTok, social media, rap, dreadlock demons. Cause he gonna send your ass to World War III to fight. Now, a lot of you, I know you're saying you ain't gonna go, this, that, another. Well, maybe you won't. Maybe you'll die in prison. Who knows? He goes on. Verse 12, I will make a man more precious than fine gold, even a man than the golden wedge of Ophir. That's what the Lord is going to do. The Lord is going to make it where men are valuable again, especially black men, so-called black men. You women, you got hell to pay coming up. And a lot of you going off to fight too. And we'll get into that in another video. I just really wanted to poke fun. But I want to read a little bit of this, and I'm going to actually cross-reference it. I'm going to read you a little bit of this. And then I'm gonna go to the NLT. So let's start right here in verse 22. Jeremiah 50 verse 22. A sound of battle is in the land and of great destruction. How is the hammer of the whole earth cut asunder and broken? And that sound of battle is what? And the great destruction, World War III, Armageddon. And the great destruction is gonna be America getting destroyed. It says, how is the hammer of the whole earth cut asunder and broken? The hammer of the whole earth is Babylon the Great. We read about it in Jeremiah 51. It says the Most High was going to make thee a burnt mountain, the mountain that destroys all the earth. He says he's going to make you a burnt mountain. Which mountains represent governments? How was the hammer of the whole earth cut asunder and broken? How has Babylon become a desolation among the nations? I have laid a snare for thee. And when you become a desolation among the nations, that's total destruction. I have laid a snare for thee, and thou art also taken, O Babylon, and thou wast not aware. Thou art found and also caught, because thou hast striven against the Lord. In this place, America, it strives against the Lord. The Most High sent his prophets to warn all the people, to let them know we're in every major city. And what did you do? Fanned your hand, talked shit, made up stuff, a bunch of videos on TikTok mocking the Hebrew Israelites. And a lot of you just making them videos, you going to fight. It says, the Lord hath opened his armory and hath brought forth the weapons of his indignation, nuclear warheads. For this is the work of the Lord, power of hosts, in the land of the Chaldeans. Representative of what? It mentioned the ancient land of the Chaldeans, but in reality, it's speaking about Babylon the Great, since this is the new place of the Chaldeans, or one that's patterned after Babylon, ancient Babylon, and the Chaldeans. Come against her from the utmost border. Open her storehouses, cut her up as heaps, and destroy her utterly. Let nothing of her be left. That's what's going to happen. Now let's jump down a little bit. You know what? Let's keep reading. It says, slay her bullocks, let them go down to the slaughter. Woe unto them, for their day has come, the time of their visitation. Right. You're going to send young men over there. These bullocks and these, you know, the different animals represent sacrificial animals. You little niggas going to get drafted into the world, into the World War III, into the military, should we say. And you're going to go to World War III and you're going to become a sacrifice, because that's really what you are. Your the term GI literally translates to galvanized iron. You're the tip of the spear. And we know that America has a great a track record of sending so-called minorities on the front lines in the hottest part of the battle. You couldn't write a better script. Slay all her bullocks, let them go down to the slaughter. You little niggas, you little ninjas, niggas, you little feminine, all different kind of alphabets. That's another thing that's going to be a trip. You think you're going to be able to flip the script? It ain't going to matter. All the pronouns go in the fight. Slay all her bullocks, let them go down to the slaughter. Woe unto them, for their day has come, the time of their visitation. The voice of them that flee and escape out of the land of Babylon, to declare in Zion the vengeance of the Lord our power, the vengeance of his temple. Right. We told you the Lord was going to take revenge. Right. Zion, you Israelites, you refuse to repent. Call together the archers against Babylon. All ye that bend the bow, camp against it round about. Let none thereof escape. Recompense her according to her work, according to all that she hath done, do unto her, for she hath been proud against the Lord, against the Holy One of Israel. That's right. And this place is proud. Okay, it's been very proud against the Lord. But guess what? You're gonna cry over the soldiers that leave over from over here. Your children to get drafted, but don't worry, you'll be soon joining them. Because the nuclear warheads are gonna come here and they're gonna annihilate this place, and everybody that's here, other than the elect of Israel, are gonna die. It says, therefore shall her young men fall in the streets, and all her men of war shall be cut off in that day, saith the Lord. Right. The Lord gonna cut people off left and right. He goes on, behold, I am against thee, O thou most proud, saith the Lord, power of hosts, for thy day is come, the time that I will visit thee. And the most proud will stumble and fall, and none shall raise him up, and I will kindle a fire in his cities, and it shall devour all round about him. So that's here in this land. You're going to be all burned up. But those that go over there to fight, they're going to die. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel and the children of Judah were oppressed together. And all that took them captives held them fast. They refused to let them go. And this proves all you all black only Israelites are saying, or those of you that say the tribe, the Judah, is over here in America, but the 10 tribes is in Africa. You a damn lie. I just said the children of Israel and the children of Judah were oppressed together. So all 12 tribes, either they're going to have to be here in Babylon the Great, and you're Israelites, like we told you, or they're over there in Africa. All 12 of the tribes, and you're not Israelites. Which one is it? And we know the answer. The answer is all the tribes over here. Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. You see? It says, the Redeemer is strong, the Lord of hosts is his name. He shall thoroughly plead their cause, that he may give rest to the land and disquiet the inhabitants of Babylon. Right. The Most High is going to cause. He's going to save his elect. That's his people. Right. Those are going to be accounted for the Lord's people, the elect of the Israelites. And he's going to destroy everybody over here. A sword is upon the Chaldeans, saith the Lord, and upon the inhabitants of Babylon, and upon her princes, and upon her wise men. Right, and these princes represent who? These young men. These young men. Alright, I want to jump down here and let's go to verse 50. I'm sorry, verse 40. It says, as the Most High overthrew Sodom and Gomorrah and the neighbor's cities thereof, saith the Lord, so shall no man abide there, neither shall any son of man dwell therein. Right. And why? Because this place is going to be a desert. Proving yet again that it's not talking about ancient Babylon, because people still live there. It says, behold, the people shall come from the north, and a great nation, and many kings shall be raised up from the coast of the earth. They shall hold the bow and the lance. They are cruel and will not show mercy. Their voice shall roar like the sea. And they shall ride upon horses, every one put in array like a man to the battle. against the old daughter of Babylon. See, so it's not actual Babylon. It's the daughter of Babylon. It says the king of Babylon had heard the report of them, and his hands waxed feeble. Anguish took hold of him, and pains as of a woman in travail. See it? Let's read the rest. It says, behold, he shall come up like a lion from the dwelling of Jordan unto the habitation of the strong, but I will make them suddenly run away from her. And who was a chosen man that I may appoint over her? For who was like me, and who will appoint me the time, and who is that shepherd that will stand before me? Therefore hear ye the counsel of the Lord that he hath taken against Babylon, and his purposes that he hath purposed against the land of the Chaldeans. Surely the least of the flock shall draw them out. Surely he shall make their habitation desolate with them. Right. And the least of the flock represent those 1948ers. They the most hated of all the Edomites. Right. And they're going to draw the rest of the Edomites into the battle. Mainly Babylon the Great. It says at the noise of the taking of Babylon, the earth is moved. That's the nuclear destruction. And the cry is heard among the nations. There you go. The Lord going to do this thing. He going to do this thing. Now I want to read right here. Just bear with me here. Jeremiah 50:30. This is what it says. Look at it. From the NLT. It says, her young men will fall in the streets and die. Her soldiers will all be killed, says the Lord. NIV, therefore, her young men will fall in the streets. All her soldiers will be silenced in that day, declares the Lord. Right. And that's over here. But also in the war, those that get drafted, they're going to die. They are going to perish. And that's good. You little TikTok, social media demons, the Lord will get rid of you. This is real quick. From the NLT, Jeremiah 50:40, he says, I will destroy it as I destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah and their neighboring towns, says the Lord. No one will live there, no one will inhabit it. Look, a great army is coming from the north, a great nation and many kings are rising against you from far off lands. They are armed with bows and spears, they are cruel and show no mercy. As they ride forward on horses, they sound like a roaring sea. They are coming in battle formation, planning to destroy you, Babylon. The king of Babylon has heard reports about the enemy, and he is weak with fright. Pains and anguish have gripped them like those of a woman in labor. And guess what? You people out there, particularly the king of Babylon, Joe Biden, and those other top people, you think they don't know that the Hebrew Israelites are prophesying that they're going to be destroyed, that America going to lose World War III and be destroyed? Surely they know. And the celebrities know. And everybody going to try to, like I said, and we've been saying, everybody's going to want to repent when it's too late. But there is a such thing as too late. So Cardi B was right about all you little TikTok social media demons. Right? She was absolutely right about you. And she's a demon herself, who the Lord's going to destroy unless you repent. So I'll leave it right there. All praise to Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai. Shalom.